Hey guys, welcome back to another Redstone video. In the background we currently see today's topic. I made a fancy, bone meal efficient brown mushroom block farm. I'm sorry about the clouds in the background. I'm using the latest snapshot and the rendering got messed up a little bit, so I can't turn them off. Alright, so brown mushroom block farm. What do I mean with bone meal efficient? So usually, if you would make a brown mushroom block farm, you would have a certain location where you grow the giant mushroom, and then you have a height limiting block, so the blocks always generate in the same spot, which makes it easy to process them further. So usually you would push them out of the contraption and store them somewhere we can later harvest them for silk touch pickaxe and instant mine. So some kind of a cube maker, something similar. Or you just blow them up in order to get mushrooms. Anyway, so having it like this with the height limiting block on top makes it easier to process the brown mushroom blocks, but it's not bone meal efficient because the brown mushroom structure actually tries to grow either 5, 6 or 7 high, or there's a 1 in 12 chance that it just doubles that value, so it could be 10, 12 or 14 high. So I made a farm that works with any height, so there's no height limiting block. No matter where the cap of the mushroom generates and how many stem blocks you get, this machine will process that. So let's check out the contraption. The player is necessary in order to place brown mushroom. So you would stand AFK here, hold down right mouse button, and always place a brown mushroom on top of the pot soil. This dropper here, by the way, would supply you with a new mushroom each time. Then you would bone meal that mushroom. It would grow into the giant mushroom. One of the stem blocks is getting powered, and this activates the harvesting. Alright, so you can turn it on here. Bone meal dispenser, just have to place down the brown mushroom. And then, as soon as it grows, we send down a flying machine that picks up the cap of the mushroom and brings it up where it's getting processed further. So we have a second flying machine that pushes them over and then processes the slices and puts all the blocks into a block stream. Okay, at the same time, we also launch a flying machine here at the bottom and pushes the mushroom stem over. Another flying machine flies it up, and the blocks are getting put into the same block stream. So they can all be processed later by the player, so mine it with the silk touch X, so I could also blow them up in order to get brown mushrooms. Right, then you can plant the next one, and no matter how high the mushroom, the giant mushroom grows, either just the smallest height or the tallest height, it would always work. The flying machine just has to fly down a little bit further in order to grab it if you have a small mushroom. The trickiest part was definitely designing the flying machine that would lift off the mushroom block cap, because we need a self-returning flying machine that works with a variable distance. And we also needed to use a sticky piston for each of the mushroom blocks, because you couldn't use a normal sticky blocks instead. So I can show the problem over here. So we basically need something that can pull the blocks up and also at the same time doesn't push through the mushroom cap. So for example, if you have 6 slime blocks that would attach 6 of the mushroom blocks, obviously we can pull this up. But the problem with the self-returning flying machine is that it needs some obstacle so it doesn't push through. So if you can easily push even further down, and that would be quite a problem for the machine. So we can still lift this up since it's only 12 blocks. If you would try to attach one more block, then obviously we couldn't lift this up anymore. So there's really no way, I think, to use normal sticky piston blocks to grab the mushroom cap. We had to use sticky pistons. There the flying machine basically flies down, and the sticky piston's position is just getting triggered and pulls up the mushroom blocks. Then the flying machine tries to push this part even further down. Obviously can't, because now there's one additional block directly in front of the sticky piston, and then it self-returns. So we can check this out over here again, real quick. Let's grow another mushroom. And there you can see it in action. The last thing this thing does is pulls up the whole top of the mushroom, and then the flying machine gets stuck and self-returns. So there were 3 challenges. First one was finding a layout out of alternating slime and honey blocks where we can attach one sticky piston to. Then second problem was we had to power each of those sticky pistons. So we had to attach observers to it, but obviously you can't power honey blocks. So we mostly had to power the slime blocks instead. We also had to attach additional blocks here on the side So the flying machine is at push limit with each of the segments. And then we also, in order to make it quite simple, we had to put in non-movable blocks here that stops the different segments, so it's easy to launch the machine again. So this was quite tricky in the end, took me quite a while, but this is a working solution. So now that we have the mushroom cap always in the same position here at the top, we can process it further. And that's why we have this quasi-flying machine that pushes everything over and it can be put here into the block stream. The problem here is that we actually need a quite slow flying machine, since this takes some time here to push the up to 7 blocks over. That's why we don't really have a flying machine, we have a quasi-flying machine. So in this direction, we triggered this piston here manually, and then it stops. It's getting all triggered by this dropper line here. For the first 3 steps, we send an item rather quickly through the chain, and then once we're about to process the whole mushroom cap with this line here on the side, we do it a bit slower. So we have a bit more delay here with the repeaters, and the item takes a bit longer to go to the next dropper and trigger the flying machine. Okay, let's check this out in action as well. All right, the blocks are about to arrive, and now we can see it nicely. First, this moves rather quick, and then we have to slow it down, so we have enough time to process all the blocks there. And on the way back, obviously this should fly back quick again. So we just pull in this observer there, and then the flying machine flies back at the normal 10 game tick cycle time. Okay, in the end, we just push the observer over again, so we can go step by step the next time. At the moment, all the blocks are pushed in front of a command block to get rid of him, but obviously in survival, you would hook this up to a block storage of your choice. I have one suggestion for such a system. And here we have such a block storage design. I made this about half a year ago, but I haven't published it yet. We'll probably do so in the next week. So this is an expandable design. You can make it even longer, but with this length here, you can handle, I think, a bit over 10,000 blocks. Right, so the mushroom blocks would arrive here. We probably just hook this up to a farm, and then stream gets split up into 2 sides and just pushed over. And once it's completely filled up, you can conveniently harvest it for your silk touch pickaxe and instant mining. Right, there's one more thing I want to mention, because if I don't do it, probably somebody in the comments would. You can also make this fully automatic, because mushrooms are also able to spread over to the pot soil, for example, and then you can just, every time this happens, bone mill it and harvest the brown mushroom, of course. But this would be rather slow, and I'm not sure if we would want to recommend that. So if you have this running passively, then you always have the chance that a flying machine might be set off in an inconvenient moment while you're about to leave your area. So you would really need to make sure this doesn't launch in the wrong moment, because obviously flying machines, if they get unloaded, will break. But technically, there's also a possibility to make a contraption that works fully automatic without the player placing the mushrooms. All right, so that's it for today. In case you want to check this out, world download is in the video description. Thanks guys for watching, see you next time, bye bye!